All right, hey guys, we're going to talk about SketchUp 25 and how you can utilize it over SketchUp 24 and look at some improvements. Today I'm here with Grant. He's in the background. He's going to try and keep me on track so we can get you guys up and running. Say good day, Grant.
Hey guys, how we going?
All right. So first things first, I'm in SketchUp 25 here. If you haven't downloaded it, or you might be a SketchUp 20 user, we'll try and clearly articulate what the benefits are, and then you can decide whether you want to upgrade into the subscription version, or you're going to stay on SketchUp 20, or you're going to stay on SketchUp 24. I believe that if you're on anything past SketchUp 21, that you probably should upgrade because you're paying for a subscription, you might as well utilize what's available. Grant, what's the main thing you like about SketchUp 25 over SketchUp 24?
It looks a lot better. It almost looks like a photo, like what the rendering programs can do. It looks a lot closer to that now. So yeah, clients are a lot happier with it, which is good.
Let's see if we can show the same model. So, okay, so this is SketchUp 24 and this is SketchUp 25. Significant difference. You can see in the background, we've got these things called environments, and you'll see I've got the little box open on the right-hand side there in my default tray. And if we go back to 24, look, this is about the best you kind of get out of SketchUp 24. Exactly the same model, by the way. We have made some tweaks and we'll explain those to you a little bit. But yeah, you can see it's a significant improvement. Now, guys, there's a lot of people that have gone through all of the features of SketchUp 25 and all of the cool things that it does. We're not going to do that today because I don't really see the point in replicating what somebody else has done. I would suggest probably going to Justin Geese, who's from SketchUp Essentials, and checking out what he's got to do. But what we're going to try and do is show you how you can utilize it to improve from an architect's or a builder's or an estimator's perspective, what you deliver to your client, the more value you can give for the same amount of time it takes you to do the work, obviously the more profitable you are or the more likely you are to convert jobs. Anything you want to add to that, Grant?
No, hit the nail on the head.
Right. Okay. So we're looking at these environments and we can turn these environments off and on, or we can edit the environments or we can change the environment. Right, which means that at the moment it looks like we're in a construction site and so on. And we'll explain a little bit more about this as we go and when to use particular environments. I'm going to go to, you've set up a scene here, Grant, present interior, correct?
That's correct.
Yes. Okay. So, and you'll notice, I'll just zoom out there and go back in. We'll have a look at that scene there and we might go over to SketchUp 24 and have a quick look at the same spot. We'll just go around to the back here, open up the doors, and you can kind of see what's going on there. I'll turn the shadows off. Look, it's about as good as you get out of SketchUp 24, but that's a significant difference in SketchUp 25. And guys, this is just a demo model. Just in case you don't have the demo model, if you're in PlusSpec, click on that help, go to help and support, check out demonstration model, and then you'll actually have access to this. If you're in SketchUp 24, you'll have the other one. You'll have SketchUp 25. You'll have this one very shortly. How long before this is live, Grant?
Hopefully in the next week.
Okay. Yeah, just so guys, if you subscribe to our YouTube channel now, it's probably a good idea because you'll get the latest update information straight away and get you know, up and running very quickly. Now, there's some problems. Not, I wouldn't say problems, but some things that are probably overlooked a little bit or you might find frustrating when you're trying to use these features of SketchUp 25. And the first one that I came across was I went into my materials and I started to add reflection and so on. So we'll just explain that. So you can see here, I'm inside of my materials. And when I select a material, say the bricks, you'll notice that you have a different type of icon showing you the material. And the reason that is that if we go into edit and we add opacity or metalness is reflectiveness, guys, and roughness to these things, I'll add metalness to it and we'll amp it up a bit. And as I go around, you'll notice that the bricks are slightly starting to reflect there. And if we reduce the roughness, we'll get more reflectivity out of it. You'll notice that now it's actually reflecting the environment, which is really good for some bricks. Like, I mean, I know that there are some glazed bricks that you can do. It means that you can actually show the client how they would reflect the environment. However, you're going to go in, no doubt, choose a model, and you're going to want to make this happen look pretty. And you, And here's what I did wrong. I didn't have, you'll notice at the top here that I have these styles here. The styles have the original SketchUp styles, which is transparent and everything else as per normal. But in SketchUp 25, it actually has a new one, which is called Display Photo Real Materials, right? So you might go in and start editing materials and not have that clicked and be a little bit frustrated. I was. I believe you were the same, Grant. And we had to figure out what was going on.
Yep.
Yeah. So, all right. So a very reflective brick, guys, unless it's a glazed brick, obviously you wouldn't do that. So, you know, put the roughness up, turn the metalness off, and you're probably going to get a more realistic brick out of that. We will show you how to do this and how to use these features in our following videos. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel now. And then as soon as they come out, you'll be up to date on how to do this. And how, look, we figured out a lot of things. It took us a couple of weeks to go through and sort this out because we had an earlier version of SketchUp because we're in the beta of SketchUp, which means we test it before everyone else. I'm going to go back to something that's probably more like what we're doing. And one thing that Grant's done in this model as well, he's actually turned the fog on because I'm just going to show you what that does. When I turn the fog off, all of a sudden we're in the middle of a paddock and it kind of is difficult to make it look realistic. So I do believe that combining fog with your environments is important, right? Environments also change things about the model. So different environments can have different reflectivities. And as I said before, go and see Justin Geese's video to learn about all that kind of stuff. But Graham, what do you think the next thing that PlusSpec users would want to know about this? Do you think it's create similar or rendered materials? What do you reckon?
I think we need to touch one more thing on the environments. Yep. So what they are is they are HDR files, file formats. If you want to, so if the ones inside of SketchUp aren't what you're after and you want to find your own ones, you can do a quick Google search. If you type in HDR free download or something like that and go to, there's a bunch of different websites, you can download them. Just okay. Important to, one thing to note on it is they can blow your model out because they are quite large if they're higher res.
Okay, so that's a good point, which leads me into something else. Now, SketchUp has updated their engine so that it makes it work quicker. And if you've ever tried to do a large project, let me just quickly show you one while we're doing this, like this, SketchUp did struggle a lot because this has got an insane amount of information inside of it. Let's see if I can maybe just show you. Now, I actually did some editing on this model, and what SketchUp's done is improve the quality of the engine behind it, basically. And which means that we can do more. Now, there's two, I think it's a two-pronged approach there, is that if we're going to add in environments and reflections and lights and things that photo more realistic, it had to have a better engine because it wouldn't have handled it. So I do applaud SketchUp for that. However, what Grant was about to say was that when we go back into this model here, is that if you have too many reflections or different scenes, and we're going to explain why you would have different scenes in a second, we might go to our interior here, Grant. Would that be the best place to go?
Yep, that's one of them. So that one there has a different environment. So you'll see on the top right of your screen there, it's got a sort of a cityscape. And we use that one, just was one of the ones that came with SketchUp. But because it was white and it gave a more realistic view from inside, because if you change this to a sky, it'll then put a bit of a blue hue throughout the internals.
More of a blue hue, actually. As you can see, I changed it then. It's significant. Right. And all of a sudden it's starting to ruin what you've designed because the environment is starting to reflect from the paint. I'm going to explain a little bit why that's happening. And I've no doubt that SketchUp will do some improvements in the future to this. But at the moment, you'll notice in this light here, it has full reflectivity with a bit of opaqueness. It's actually reflecting the outside environment instead of the ceiling, the walls, and the kitchen. Right. And if I change the environment, it's actually changed this. So I think the majority of thoughts or things that I've seen on other reviews of SketchUp 25 have actually mentioned this. However, as I showed earlier, there's still a significant improvement. It's just a matter of dealing with the reflectivity and choosing the correct scene to make your building look as realistic as possible and working with what you've got now. Is there anything you want to add to that, mate?
No, that's pretty much it. Just if you're downloading ones from online, just try and find what. Don't use the 4K ones, for example, because they might be 16 megs. You can use a 2K one that'll be maybe a quarter of the size. So just consider that when you're doing it.
Keeping the file size small is something we've always been banging on about. And the thing about PlusSpec is what it does is it organizes and draws geometry, but it keeps it at a level of detail, which is high. However, it's optimized to make it work correctly. Would that be the right way to look at that, Grant?
That's correct, yeah.
Okay, so, but one thing that we did do and what you're going to get in this next release, as I said before, follow the channel to get it notified about it, is that we actually automatically have added the right attributes to materials. And I'll quickly explain that roughly. We talked about metalness and we talked about roughness. And then you have roughness maps and you have ambient occlusion maps that you can apply to a material. Now, this is a lot to learn when your job is to deliver plans to clients. So we thought, how about we automate this for you? So I'll give you an example. I'm going to go right click, create similar wall. I might just any of these walls, doesn't really matter. Walls, right click and create similar wall. And I'm just going to draw it over here. Right here. Really close. All right. And it automatically has more depth. And just to show you that in SketchUp 24, which I may have closed. I must have. So what we did is we gave the right reflective materials to the windows. We gave the right reflective materials to the walls and added the ambient occlusion and everything to the materials to make them more realistic, to save you having to manually do this. So whether you're creating a new wall or whether you're creating a new roof or anything like that, you should have the right attributes according to the material in there. Would that be the best way to put that, Grant?
That's correct. So any of the PlusSpec materials will come with that information with it. And coming as well, there will be the ability to, when you're creating your own materials, to assign that information. You don't have to, but if you want to, it will be there to do so.
All right. So I think that's enough on materials and environments, because they can find out more and plenty of other videos. Let's try and kick this puppy home by giving the most amount of information with the least amount of words. All right. So we also added some elevations here, and you'll notice that in the tutorial model that we've actually given it a bit more depth, and we've quickly sent some things to layout, and we'll touch on that in a second. But you can now see it gives your drawing a lot more depth. And I think probably now is a good time to quickly jump to layout and see if we can show you this. Right. So at the top here and at the bottom here, we have SketchUp 25, but we've just simulated what SketchUp 24 would have looked like. And you can see, let's just look at these two here, that we have more depth. It looks so much better the way it is. And we've added ambient occlusion into those scenes there, just so that we get a better understanding of, or have our the viewers of the plan have a better understanding at a glance. And it also looks more professional, I believe. And whether you're going to do color or black and white, you can now give your drawings a heap more depth. Would that be the best way to put it, Grant? Is there anything that you can?
No, that's exactly right. It's just putting a bit of shading around just to put things more in the foreground and in the background, so things pop a bit more.
Yeah, and which is, look, I don't know if you've ever seen a Revit or an ArchiCAD drawing. They're very, very flat. And I think that what this is doing for architects or drafters or building designers is showing more of their skills and delivering better output, which I think that's what SketchUp 25 is excelling at. Is there anything you got to add to that, Grant?
No, that's everything.
Okay. So, Grant, guys, by the way, this is live. We haven't cut it. We haven't scripted it. We haven't done anything. So we're kind of talking amongst each other to try and give you the best information. Grant, what else do you think is important to be showing the guys right now? Because I've got a couple of things I want to talk about. But
There's a couple of, you know, just quality of life improvements. You know, I know everyone that's done drafting or, you know, setting a model up for drafting or any scenes or anything like that, where as soon as you add in a new layout tag, and then assign geometry to that, you've then got to hook it up for every scene. So they've just made changes with that. Inside of SketchUp, yeah. So you can turn a layer, a couple of layers on and off, or a bunch of different layers, and then select the scenes that you want to apply that change to, and then just right click and do that. So it's just, yeah.
Well, look, guys, we'll get into this in more detail and show you how to do it. But I did find it really frustrating when I actually went and drew a model and then got it all up to date. And anyway, I think I've actually got an example in here. Let's have a look. Come reframing buttons. Okay. Still engineering. Right. You'll notice that things have been added in after the engineering was starting to be put together. And I would like to turn certain things off or certain layers off on multiple scenes without having to go through one by one by one and updating. It actually is a pretty good, it's a big improvement, I believe, from SketchUp to help that out. But we won't get caught in today. As I said, we will get back to that later on. But, you know, there's some cool stuff that actually has happened there. Grant, anything else we want to touch on that?
No, I think you've got everything there.
They haven't made a great deal of difference with drawing tools either. The only thing is that now you can sort of curves on faces and so on a little bit quicker. Again, that's in the Justin Geese video if you want to see that. IFC. So I come at this from two different approaches, from a design perspective and then a estimating perspective and a construction perspective, virtual design and construction. And we know that a lot of people use Revit in what they do. And then we've got a lot of PlusSpec users who use PlusSpec because they want to quantify a Revit model. Well, SketchUp has the ability to import a Revit model correctly. And I just quickly imported this. I don't even know where it came from. I quickly looked up .rvt file. And basically the advantages are that we can turn layers off on Revit files and they're more organized. However, I'll put a link in the video now just so that you can go to and figure out how to quantify these things, because IFC and Revit files are part of our workflow. And we want to ensure that you guys can have an external architect give you stuff. You can quantify it, get it to your subcontractors and everything like that. So IFC and Revit, there are some good improvements, and we can deal with more larger models because of the engine behind SketchUp working more efficiently. Grant, have we got anything else on? Have you got a bullet point or something that we can go to from here? Where are we at now?
I think we've covered either all or most of the important stuff that's in 25 that, you know, using with PlusSpec as well, and what's going to be useful for both. So yeah, yep. I think we've covered quite a lot of it actually.
Yeah. Okay. Look, there is one thing that I did find slightly helpful, and I might just quickly touch on that now. I'm not sure if you're aware of this, Grant. Let's just quickly draw a couple of rectangles. And one thing that I found frustrating with SketchUp before was that it didn't update certain things with quantities. Let's see if I can just go to large tool set. There we go. Large tool set there. When we click on a face, and this is in Justin Geese's video as well, it's quantifying it. But before it was static, whereas now when we actually move a face, it's updating the quantities. Kind of can be handy, especially if you're doing floor space ratios or anything like that, and you're making adjustments you want to see live where you're at. I think it's a handy thing. You're aware of that, Grant?
I've learned something new today.
There you go. Well, hopefully everyone learns a bit of something new every day. And hopefully our videos are giving you some good insights without too much crap, guys. So by all means, if you've got anything that you would like us to show in the upcoming videos, ask them below in the questions. Don't forget to like the video if you like it. And if you didn't like it, push dislike. But if you push dislike, make sure you tell us why, because I reckon if people go in there and say, what are these dislikes, and they don't read a comment from you, I don't know, spam, I guess. What do you think, Grant? Or anything else you want to finish off here, buddy?
No, I'm pretty happy with all that. I think 2025 is looking pretty good, and keen to see what else it can do.
All right, guys. Look forward to hearing your feedback, and seeing you in the next video. Cheers.
Cheers, guys. See ya.